version of SPSS, you can only install it one at a time, as in once in I think 1 year. Okay, in so it is one
free. Professor time. Vishal, you're
yes.
Not very clear. Can you just use your mic?
I'm using that.
Okay, can you make it put it a bit closer?
Okay. Hello, is this little better?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, it's better now.
Okay. So now you see this.
Just 1 minute. Yes. I'm muting all of you, please. And you can only unmute when the host allows you. Thank you.
Okay. So if some of you had already been working with a trial version, you cannot use it again. So it is one free trial per computer per year. And if your 14-day period is over, then also you may not be able to open it, even if you have installed it or so you will have to, if you have somebody to help you out, please check at your end, or if you can borrow somebody else's machine. You will have to fill in these details, okay? Verify your details, then it will prompt you to a page where it will ask you to download, and then you install. Follow the instructions of installing SPSS, right? So Amos Vasundhara, I am not sure if it is available. I think it is not available for Apple and Mac products. Okay, so again, you will have to maybe work on some Windows machine or maybe take help from somebody around you. I really cannot help you much on this. Okay, I am not aware of. Basically, it is very difficult to even get a crack of these things. So I don't really have an idea here. Okay, so maybe we'll get started. And can we go to Sudhanshu and let Sudhanshu ask his question before we start our hands-on session?
Sir, am I audible?
Yes, you are audible. Yes.
Sir, I have two questions. First is, using the trial version and sending the paper for publication, is it ethical enough to use a trial version? And, do we need to recognize the fact that we've used trial version? And do we need to mention that in the paper? And my second question is, can I ask the second question, sir?
Yeah.
So my second question was, as a layman initially, before attending this seminar of yours, I thought reliability was more to do with the consistency over a period of time. So I thought there was a temporality aspect associated with reliability. But right now, as you said, reliability is just, squaring out all the random error, and then probably validity is, squaring out the random error plus the other error that you mentioned. So why temporality is not an important issue for the robustness of a scale?
So actually, to answer your first question, I don't think it is a problem if you are using trial version and reporting the results. Remember, you will be able to use it only for 14 days, and IBM itself has given you license to use it. So it is not that you are doing something unethical. You are using the trial version to do your analysis, and if you can do it in 14 days, write it out, send it out, I don't think it is a problem. Okay, so you feel free to use the trial version also, and you don't need to write in the paper. You can just say, I used SPSS to do my analysis, because the company itself is giving you that license for 14 days. The second thing that you mentioned, consistency over time, actually this, we have a special kind of reliability which we call as test retest reliability. So the first aspect of reliability that we talked about is doing the analysis and understanding whether there is a good inter-item correlation, and through that you are trying to understand whether you can because there is good inter-item correlation, the items are able to capture an underlying latent construct. Once you have that, okay, once you are sure, so this reliability testing will tell you that these items are good measures of your latent construct. Now, what you can do is you can even, and it is actually done in a lot of cases, you can administer the test to people today, okay, and administer the test to people again at a later time, right? And then check the correlation between the items that you got at time one and at time two, okay? And see whether there is good correlation between items, okay? And that again will give you, the test retest, test retest reliability, and you are checking for consistency of item over time. If you go to this chapter of Madhu Vishwanathan and go to page number 30, let me show you, he actually says that, you see, test retest reliability, so testing the items over time. So PNI scale was administered to 106 graduate students twice. So the same students, 106 students, were given this test at an interval of 1 week. Longer intervals should be used, and it has been used for even 12-week interval. 12 weeks mean after 3 months, okay? And you see the total scale, it was the correlation between the total set of items, 20 items, time one and time two, the correlation was 0.91 at 1 week interval, and was 0.73, right? Then item one, so for each item also there is test retest reliability. Mean score at test is 4.64 and retest it is. So you see, you are actually showing that there is significant correlation, okay? And there are few items like item 2, item 12, right, item 18. These are items that are maybe giving you. So you can quote these kind of numbers. But remember, Cronbach's alpha is not is computed at one time. So you will compute Cronbach alpha at time one and then time 1 week later. Okay. There is no specific index for reliability like Cronbach's alpha for test retest reliability. You just show test retest correlations and show that the items show good correlation over time as well. That means the items have been stable. So you do that, a lot of people do that, but mostly when you are developing a scale, people report Cronbach alpha and some people report test retest. A lot of people actually don't report this test retest.
Yes, sir. Thank you very much. Okay.